Hello, my name is Richard Spaide. I'm a vitreoretinal surgeon with the Vitreous Retina Macular Consultants of New York. I'd like to talk to you about a condition called central serous chorioretinopathy. Now, that's a big word. Sometimes we call it CSC or we call it central serous for short. This is an interesting entity that was discovered in the 1800s, and a lot has learned about the psychosocial aspects of this disease, plus the anatomy and all the other changes that occurred over the last 100 years. Central serous is a condition that typically occurs in men, and oftentimes they seem to be stressed or they have a lot of stress in their life. And they can develop leaks of fluid underneath the retina, and the retina gets ballooned up by this fluid. And the patients get distorted vision and decreased central vision because of this fluid. We have a number of interesting treatment modalities based on our ideas about this disease. In the 1920s, people started getting the idea that patients with central serous chorioretinopathy maybe had more stress, or there was some kind of factor that these patients seemed a little bit different than patients with other ocular diseases. And this idea kept developing until early World War II, where most of the patients who developed central serous were men. And they were men in wartime conditions. And people put that link together that maybe stress involved in war was somehow related to an eye disease. After the war, in the 50s, interesting thing is that more and more women were described with central serous chorioretinopathy. In the 1960s, Dr. Momini injected a dye called fluorescein into the eye, and he looked at the fluorescein with his eye and saw that there were leaks of fluorescein dye from a deeper layer of the eye, and this caused fluid to accumulate underneath the retina. Shortly following that, there was development of fluorescein angiography, which used film photography to record that. And they were able to see leaks underneath the retina associated with this disease. Didn't know how to treat it at the time. So some enterprising ophthalmologist got the idea of, well, maybe we should treat those leaks with a laser. And recall right around that time was the invention of ruby laser. So central serous chorioretinopathy was the first disease ever treated with a laser. And in fact, it worked. So this formed the basis of much of our treatment through the 1980s, in fact. More recently, we've been treating this disease using other modalities, which I'll talk about soon. Typically, a patient with central serous will come in with complaints of decreased central vision with distortion as well. And they may have prolonged after images where they see green or purple images after looking at a bright light. And that after image may last for quite a bit of time. The problem, when the eye doctor looks inside the eye, we see a detachment of the retina, a detachment of the macula. One diagnostic instrument that's very helpful for central serous chorioretinopathy is a new technique called optical coherence tomography. This instrument gives us cross-sectional images of the eye, and we're able to see the detachment of the macula. We're also able to see deeper down into another structure called a choroid. The choroid is an area where there's many blood vessels that are densely packed inside the eye. We discovered at the Vitreoretinal Macular Consultants of New York that the blood vessels in the choroid are too leaky, and this leakage increases the pressure inside the choroid, and it breaks through and pushes up the retina, and that's where the fluid comes from. Using a new form of optical coherence tomography, we showed that the choroid becomes thicker with this disease. So we have a way to follow these patients. We can look at the thickness of the choroid, and we can look at the amount of fluid underneath the retina. If the central serous has been present for a period of time, we can treat this, and we can attack the leakiness of the blood vessels in the retina, or we can do laser therapy on the leaks themselves. So we can detect the root of the problem by treating the choroid. The retina flattens out and the vision generally gets better. This still is an interesting disease in that it's driven by stress. And stress can happen in a number of different ways. Certainly somebody has a death in the family or moves or has a new job or something like that. That's kind of an external sort of stress. Many times it's an initiating factor for the development of central serous. Another group of people that we see, particularly in New York, are people who use stress to kind of as a drug or adrenaline to get themselves psyched up to do a job. And these are often very successful people, and they're under stress, and they kind of thrive on that stress. But the stress comes out in different ways, sometimes as central serous. So I had one lawyer, for instance, who told me that he has a lot of stress inside, and it comes out through his eyes as central serous. So we talk to patients not only about their disease, but also a little bit about stress management.